Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and my favorite thing about mechanical keyboards is the ability to customize them to whatever I want. I can make them look how I want, sound like I want, feel like I want. And I can also make them do what I want. And I can use software like Via, which is a web-based app that lets you customize a lot of keyboards. A ton of keyboards are supported by this app, not just the ones I'm gonna show you today, but a ton of keyboards can be reprogrammed to work how you want. And today I'm gonna show you how I've done some light customization to my Mode Envoy keyboard, which is my normal main keyboard, which I really love. This is an awesome keyboard. You don't have to buy it. I'll put a link in the description, but there's tons of keyboards that do this and a lot that are less expensive, but I'm gonna show you how I did some minor customizations to make this work more how I wanted. And then I'm gonna show you this, which is a macro pad. The specific model doesn't really matter that much. I've only had it for a few weeks and I'm not prepared to do a full review, but they all are gonna be kind of the same idea of, here's 16 buttons and 3 knobs. You can customize them to do whatever you want. I'm gonna show you how we do that in Via right now. Okay, so we are on the Mac now, and this is the website for the Mode Envoy. And if we scroll down a bit, you're gonna see a few of the buttons here. Yeah, so on the rightmost side, the standard buttons that come here are home, page up, page down, and then the right arrow key. And you can see them over here as well. But I don't use those keys that much, and I don't really need those super frequently. So what I wanted to do was customize them. And as you can see here on my keyboard, I have delete, volume up, volume down, and play pause. And those are better fits for me. They're things that I use more often. So how did I do that? So you want to go to Via, just use via.app. If you want to go to Can I Use Via, they also have a compatibility checker. They have a list of supported keyboards. If you go to start now, that's going to be the Use Via. So you have to use a Chromium-based browser. So I'm using Arc. Chrome would work. Opera should work. Brave browser should work. But Firefox and Safari will not. So authorize the device. I have 2 keyboards plugged in, so it's going to give me 2. The name is not always super obvious, but let's start with this one, which I happen to know is the Mode Envoy. So when you load it up, you're going to see kind of a representation of your keyboard, and you're going to see a whole bunch of keys down here. There's basic keys, media control keys, macros, which we'll get into shortly, layers, special, and lighting. So in general, basic are just like the basic keys on the keyboard, the P key, the F6 key, right? Media is next track, previous track, play pause, the volume up and down, those sorts of things. Macros are typically keyboard shortcuts or keyboard expansion things. Again, we'll get into those. I'll show you some examples. Layers are an interesting thing. So if you've ever like held down the FN key on a keyboard, that's switching to another layer. And so you can see when I hold down the FN key, actually nothing happens here. What are the layers? Oh yeah, this is FN1. So that's gonna be this guy, which changes my keys to these. Again, we'll get into this. Special, these are special characters, special keys, like the extended F rows. You can do some stuff with the mouse even. And then lighting, if your keyboard has RGB or any lighting at all, this is where these controls are. So to basically program this, all you do is click one of the buttons. It's gonna start subtly flashing, pulsing. And then you just choose what key you want it to be. So let's do, it's gonna be hard to show one of these, but let's do 6, right? So now this top right key right here is a 6 key. So if I just bring up Raycast and hit this button, a 6 types. So that's how easy it is. You don't have to save anything. You just click it, choose the key you want. I'm gonna put it back to delete. And then if I bring up Raycast again, we'll just type out some numbers, move over here, and if I hit delete now, the 7 should delete, and it does. So I like having the delete in the top right. That's what I put there, and then volume up, volume down. I'm actually hooked up in a way this won't work right now, but if I was using AirPods or some other speaker that I could control the volume, these would function correctly. And hitting play is going to actually open the music app now. It would also play and pause if I'm listening to something. So those are what I've got configured. And again, I can go in and change them to whatever I want. So basic keys, totally awesome. And those are very subtle things. Oh, you also might notice my caps lock key actually doesn't caps lock. It actually does the tilde key, which I use quite a bit for doing code blocks and those sorts of things. So I actually don't have caps lock enabled, although the key is caps lock because the width is wider. Anyway, I make it work. So that's kind of the basic idea. And again, FN1, these are layers. So when I hold down this key, that's gonna bring up the layer one. Layer zero is the default, and then layer one is these. And so basically when I hold down these, that turns my numbers into the function row. It puts print screen up in the top right, which is useful for when I'm plugged into a Windows computer, and volume up, volume down, and play remain on those. That is another thing I should note, is that you are not doing something specific for this computer. You are actually changing the programming of the keyboard itself. So if you plug this into another random computer where you've never done this customization, the keyboard's still going to behave the same way because those keys actually mean different things now. So yeah, that's kind of the basic customization you can do. But let's go to the macro pad. So we're going to authorize a new device, the Doio. Not really sure. Connect, there we go. Don't know why I had to do it twice, but now you can see this one's loaded up. And I don't have as many things here. I'm actually still playing around with this to do more, but yeah, I don't have quite as many things, but I do have a couple things loaded up. So down here at the bottom, I have previous, play, and next. So that's for music control. Again, it's kind of duplicating what I have on the keyboard with the like play pause, but yeah, previous, play, and next. So I can just hit this to play, hit this to go to the next track, and this to go back. Then I have all of these other ones, mode, MO3. So this is when I hold it down, it switches to the RGB control. So I think this one, if I hold this and that, yeah, that triggers the RGB, and then I can change the hue, the mode, the saturation, like all these things about the RGB. I actually don't want it, so I'm just going to toggle it back off. But yeah, we're not going to get into those layers, but that's kind of the idea. Is if I just press one of these buttons now, it's going to do one thing. If I hold and switch to another mode, it's going to do another thing, or another layer, I should say. But what are these macros? So if you hover over them, you can actually see them in their kind of code version. It's not code, but you kind of get the idea. It's basically showing what happens when I press these keys. And so I take a ton of screenshots, and I know the keyboard shortcuts, but it's kind of like you have to make your hand into a bit of a claw to make some of them work. And so it's nice for me to just be able to go, bam, full screen screenshot. Got it. I want to start recording a video in clean shot. There we go. And I can go ahead and start scaling this and doing what I want. It's nice to have these up here, right? Take a screenshot of the section. So I, again, since I take so many of those, it's easier now for me to just go up here and kind of feel which key it is, hit it, and know that I have a screenshot. So those are useful for me. This is full screen area, F5. This is kind of their like remember, so it will redo the last thing you did. So if you want to take the same screenshot multiple times, this isn't a video about clean shot, but yeah. And then video is this one. So I have those set up. Additionally, this is kind of a cool one. Let's say I have, let's go back to the Mode Envoy page, right? One of the cool things you can do with things is quickly save things that you want to save to things in things with a universal keyboard shortcut. I have that configured to this button now. So I can just hit this button and I've instantly created a new task with the name of this page, with the URL, and then I can tab through and say, this is due today, in what project, we'll do the shopping project. Save it, there we go. And if I go over to things, there it is, right? So that's really nice. I just have a one button save thing where I can save things to things. I'll stop saying things now. I also have one, if we go back to Via, I also have down here, M13, so macro number 13. Again, that's pressing a long keyboard shortcut. But what I have is I write my blog posts in Ulysses, and I save highlights from Readwise in to Obsidian. So they're syncing over to Obsidian. I've made a whole video about this setup, but basically when I have a quote that I want to make a link post about, all I have to do now is hit this button and it instantly takes the quote, formats it over here, and I have a link post where I can just start writing here, right? This is awesome. So that's some of the things that I'm using it for already. You can see I already have some spaces left to go where I can add more little shortcuts. Also the wheels, I haven't really talked about the wheels. If I spin this guy around, this is volume control. If I press it, it's gonna mute. Press it again, it should unmute. That might've been too quick. Let's see, what is it doing? It's just mute. Let's change this. So this is an interesting thing. KCVOLD, this is volume down, volume up, and then mute. So this is only muting, it'll never unmute. So I wanna toggle mute. How do you do that? So what you actually wanna do is, let's go to media. There's a mute key, which is at KC mute. You can see it kind of down, I can't move my mouse, but down near the bottom of the screen, mute audio. If I click onto this, KC mute is the text that's there. For the wheels, for whatever reason, you actually just have to type in the keyboard shortcut. You can't actually press a thing. So how can I toggle mute? Is that a thing? There's mute, media stop, slide password. Is it under special? You'd think there'd be like a toggle mute option. Maybe there's not. There's music on, music off, but I don't think that's quite right. Music toggle, music mode, audio on, audio off. Well, maybe there isn't a way to do that. Let me know in the comments if there's something stupid I'm missing here. But I guess it's not the end of the world. Just smash it to mute it and then just raise the volume by turning it to bring it back. I don't know. Weird. Can't figure it out. This one I actually have set to scroll the mouse wheel left and right. And if I press that, it'll go home. So I think if I scroll down, press this, yeah, that doubles as the home button. And if I'm in a, let's see, we'll bring up Final Cut Pro real quick. Hopefully I've got a project I was recently working on here. You kind of know what you're going to see here, but give that a second to load. There we go. So if we zoom all the way in and I start turning this, it's going to scroll either way. If you don't have a keyboard with a way to scroll sideways, this could be useful. But yeah, nice little thing there. And this one is page up and page down. So if I go back to this page, it's a way to scroll quickly through something. Again, not always useful, but there are situations where this is actually pretty nice for me personally. So let's go ahead and make a macro. So if we go down here to macros, you can see there's M0 through M15. So there's up to 16 macros you can configure. And there's nothing for M0, but if we look at like M1, that's Command Shift 3 down, all three of those down, and then all three of those up. So again, it's simulating Command Shift 3. Do it that way, or do it this way with M1. So one thing I do is I lock my computer pretty frequently. So let's go to M0. Let's just start with M0. So what I can do here is I need to know what keys I want to press. And so to lock my computer, it's Command Control Q. And so if I hit that now, it's going to lock the screen briefly. I'm going to have to remember to blur out the video while I type in my keyboard or my password. But yeah, so that's the keystroke I want to simulate, is Command Control Q. So what I can do is I can either go full screen here and then I can record. I think this is not going to work though, because it's actually going to log me out, or it's going to lock the screen. So I don't know if it'll capture it. Let's try it. Record. Okay. Did that work? Yeah, it doesn't work. So as soon as I hit the Q button, it didn't like that. So we need to actually, let's see, can I do undo changes? Yeah. So we actually need to use this option here, which is to type it out, right? And it gives you some guidance here, but it's not super obvious. I will say that basically all of them are start KC underscore. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go over here. And we want to do, so it's going to be, here we go, left control, Left win is actually what command is called. These names are a little Windows centric, but yeah. So L win, so L GUI, L CTL, and then Q I think is just Q. Yeah. So okay. So unfortunately, we have to memorize those. So we're in M0. KC underscore L GUI, and then comma to do multiple at the same time, KC underscore LCTL, and you can see it's kind of auto-completing for me to make sure I do a correct one, and Q, right? So there we go. So that's gonna hit Command, Control, Q. Save it. There we go. And now we should see Command, Control, Q. Awesome. And that's set to M0, but no key has been set to do that yet. So let's set this guy right here. So go back to our key map, go to macros, click on this guy, M0, and there we go. So now hitting this key right here should log me out, or lock my screen at least. And it did. So excellent. Beautiful. So now I have a one key press I can do to just lock my screen, which is great, which is nice. and so that's the sort of thing you can do. So depending on what you use your computer for, depending on the sorts of keyboard shortcuts you are often doing and how annoying you find them, you can find some things to do here. But yeah, just being able to make small adjustments to your normal keyboard, I find really nice. And then if you want to do more, a macro pad like this can be really nice to kind of extend your keyboard and make it kind of just something that's very custom built for you. So hopefully this slightly different style of video, a little less editing, less no script at all, just kind of just going as I think about it, was helpful. Hopefully it gave you an idea for how VIA works. And yeah, like I said, when I'm buying a keyboard, which is much less now that I have the Mode Envoy, which is very good, very, very good. I don't find myself buying keyboards anymore, really. But when I am shopping for a keyboard, I really need it to have VIA support so that I can do little things like this to make it perfect for me. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.